small places or like huge festivals? I know that every place has this mystique, but what do you prefer?
I like both. I mean, that's, I love to play deeper or harder. I mean, I don't mind. I kind of like these kind of challenges. I mean, the most difficult is not about the size of the venue, it's about the crowd. When the crowd expects something like very commercial, for instance, like very like EDM or this kind of thing, that's the most difficult. Because you have to find a way to please these people who don't have a big knowledge about this kind of music. And that's not about playing harder or deeper. You have to find a way to please these guys, that's always very difficult. Without playing commercial, because I don't play commercial, so that's a possibility. I don't know if you had this kind of experience. It's very difficult. Very difficult.
Le preguntaba de qué prefería más, si tocar en festivales o en lugares under. Dice que cada uno tiene su magia, pero con el tema de los festivales es muy difícil cuando la gente quiere escuchar cosas comerciales y él no las tiene.
Well, if you don't have that thing, that kind of music, what do you do? Because if you, for example, if you prepare live sets, what do you do?
When I play live and I am in front of this kind of crowd, I'm totally fucked up. Obviously, there's no way to escape. But usually I try to negotiate and play DJ, because then I can play this old school house from the 80s, you know, like Inner City, this kind of thing, and that always works. You know, this like, I don't know, Kenny Dope, all these things, because that's warm, that's housey, that's catchy, and usually that works.
Le pregunté que cómo hacía en esas circunstancias donde le piden cosas comerciales. Y bueno, si él está tocando con un live set, es totalmente imposible. Pero si está como DJ, puede poner cosas más de los 80s, como Inner City, y ese tipo de cosas sirven.
Something happens to me like pretty... Yeah, actually it happens pretty usually. I played here like 2 weeks ago, and they started to ask for some reggae and some reggaeton. If someone came and told you that, what are you going to do?
Nothing, because I don't have any reggaeton. No, I mean, sometimes if I play DJ and if I have a request and if I feel the track, sometimes, yeah, I play it, but it's quite difficult to... I cannot do, you know, this kind of request. It's kind of difficult.
Le preguntaba qué pasa si alguien le va y le dice, bueno, quiero escuchar un poco de reggaetón. Y dice, bueno, no puedo hacer nada porque no tengo esa música. Entonces es como bastante complicada la situación, pero bueno, son las cosas que pasan.
You told me that in the studio you have a lot of hard work. What do you use, what do you prefer, what do you like? Tell us something about the studio. It's a huge studio, it's a small one.
Le preguntaba acerca del estudio. Le preguntaba acerca del estudio, qué es lo que tiene, qué es lo que no tiene, cómo trabaja, porque él me comentó que tiene muchas cosas de hardware.
Yes, actually I use a mix of digital and analog technologies. I use a mix of computer, digital audio workstation based system, and I still use a lot of hardware synthesizers from the 70s and the 80s. Not only for the sound, because I think that a lot of software synthesizers sounds great, but I need it for my workflow. I need this kind of connection with the instrument. You know, you can really have this feeling and connection with your body. You know, and I like it. You can tweak knobs and everything, and that's the way I like to work. So I have, I mean, that's not a huge studio, but I've got something like maybe 12 synthesizers. Yeah.
That's 12
more than
I have.
Yeah. And I also have a lot of guitar pedals, like old ones, you know, phasers, flangers, delays, I have a lot of shit actually. And but I love to play with it, like it's like toys.
Yeah.
And you spend time with it, and then you find new ideas. That's a good way to generate things, you know. And
After a while, I just realized that when we get older, we like the same toys, but they're really expensive.
Exactly.
That's the only difference.
That's exactly the same. Okay,
Le pregunté qué cosas tenía en el estudio. Me dice que él trabaja mucho con sintetizadores viejos, con pedales de guitarra, con flangers, que tiene 12 sintetizadores, que es como 12 veces más de los que tengo yo. Así que bueno, tiene como bastantes cosas divertidas para jugar ahí.
Well, do you manage to produce something when you are traveling, or it's just on the studio?
That when I travel, I try to record ideas, you know. So I always have my laptop computer with a couple of samples, softwares, synthesizer, everything. And I try to write ideas everywhere, because inspiration is everywhere, basically. And then when I'm back in the studio, I import all these tracks and all these loops into my computer, and then I finish the track. But I never managed to finish a track in a hotel room. There's no way. I cannot do that. I don't have the... It's too abstract for me. I need to be in my studio, but I wish I could do, because I spend a lot of time in hotels, so I could... Okay, let's record an album. We have 2 days.
Me dice que no, que él cuando está viajando le cuesta mucho poder producir. Sí genera ideas y las marca y hace ese tipo de cosas, pero no poder producir un tema. Necesita, siente como que esto es demasiado abstracto, entonces que precisa estar en el estudio como para sentir un poco más las cosas. Well, we're talking about the studio. Which VST are you using? And how do you master your tracks?
You mean like instruments or instruments and tools? Yeah, I use a lot of everything for native instruments, basically. Like I have the machine, but I love to use Absent, FM8, Kontakt, Basic, all the battery a lot. I love the software. It's great sounding and easy to use. I use a lot of Waves plugins as well. When it's about EQing and compression, I use a lot of UAD things. You know, the one with the card in the computer. I use a lot because they really sound great. I use a couple of synthesizers from Arturia, like the Minimoog, and that's pretty all, I think.
Bueno, me estaba diciendo que utiliza los sintetizadores de Arturia, como el Minimoog, por ejemplo, cosas del paquete de Waves, todo lo que viene de Native Instruments, como que tienen un gran sonido.
Well, now let's go to some other sides. When did you start like producing and you tried to sign your tracks with the label? How did you start?
My first project was called The Youngster, so it was in the late 90s, and the scene was definitely not the same. It was smaller, and the network was definitely not the same. So it was just about doing very small thing, but trying to make it bigger, you know. So yeah. My first record, I did it with a friend on a very small French label called G-Funk. And we met in south of France, and we had this small label. And then Laurent Garnier began to play this record, and then we met him, and then we signed on his communication in 2000, 2001, and then it became bigger. So it's how it all began, actually. And then when F Communication stopped in 2007, I think, I wanted to do something else, so I began to produce as Rodriguez Junior. And I decided to start everything from scratch, so I began to send demos again to you know, and it was very difficult. It was in 2007, and I needed like 1 year to find the good labels, and so I released music on Boxer, on Mothership, Lina, on a lot of different labels, and then Mobile, and then it works. But it was a great experience to start something from scratch and to feel to be once again in this position where you have to send demos and people don't know you, and it was quite exciting in a way, and it was difficult but exciting because you have to prove people that you can do it, you know. So I kind of love it.
Bueno, me estaba comentando que empezó con un amigo editando en un sello muy chiquitito en el sur de Francia hace muchos, muchos años. Después, bueno, tuvo contacto con Laurent Garnier, empezaron con todo un tema de comunicación. Y recién como Rodríguez Junior fue a partir del año 2007, entonces fue todo un desafío nuevo para él.
porque comenzó a enviar demos nuevamente y es como que tenía que probarle a la gente que su música valía. Y,
well, when you get into mobile, like something changed, because it's a huge level. Maybe it was not in that time, but there was like a click.
Yes, sure, because they spend a lot of energy and time on promoting music, and also they have got a great booking politic. Everything is connected together, and I think that's a good way to work nowadays. Booking is connected with promotion, it's connected with the releases, it's connected with beatbox, with everything, and it works perfectly together. So definitely, I mean, it like years to get into it and to make it happen, but after a while it was perfect. I really cannot complain.
Dice que cuando comenzó a trabajar con Mobile, lo que tiene de bueno este sello es que trabajan como muy interconectado con todo, con Beatport, con el booking, con la música, absolutamente con todo. Entonces sí, como que no tiene ningún tipo de queja al respecto.
Well, it was my pleasure to interview you. It was my pleasure to play with you yesterday, so thank you so much for all of this.
My pleasure too, Christian. Mucho gusto.
Well,
here we are. Le estaba agradeciendo muchísimo por todo lo que vivimos, por esta entrevista, por los tragos, por el toque, por todo. Así que bueno, este fue una nueva emisión aquí en Golden Wings Report.